name is Ronnie Jollis, and I am an artist, and I work with paper. I live here in Great Falls, and I'm honored that you're going to be learning about my work. I'm just going to start by telling you a little about my life and how I got to where I am right now. I was born in Rochester, New York, and I was the youngest of four daughters. My mother was an artist, and she did all kinds of interesting things. She carved stone, she carved wood, she welded metal, and she did watercolors. And actually, this is just an example of one of her watercolors that you can see. She was really quite an amazing artist. The reason I didn't think I could be an artist is my mother was a very shy, quiet person. She didn't really like to be around a lot of people. I'm much more social, like my father, who was a lawyer, and I thought, I can't be in my studio alone all day. So I didn't even think it was possible for me to be an artist. So I spent almost 20 years teaching art to basically middle school, 5th through 8th grade. And I loved it. I loved teaching art. I loved teaching drawing, painting, printmaking, everything. I really loved teaching art. So once I stopped teaching and decided I wanted to become a full-time artist, I wasn't quite sure what material I wanted to work with. I was looking for something that would be unique and something that would be all mine. And I started doing collage. This was the first collage I ever did as a professional artist. And it is just using paper. It's flat. And it was when I was just beginning in collage. Since then, I have learned a lot about paper and all the papers in the world. I learned how to make paper, and paper making is fun, very time consuming, and I found out I could make paper, but then I didn't get to do anything with it. So I'd rather get the paper from other people making it and then use it as my form of art. And just out of interest, this is a piece I just did that was kind of based on that first piece. It was inspired by this one. I don't know if you can see the similarity. But this one is much more how I work now, which is it kind of sticks out from the canvas and it's different kinds of papers that I cut. So there's much more texture in this one. And texture is one of the things that I try to get in my artwork. And I can do that by my paper. And I just want to show you my paper closet. This is some of the papers I have. I organize them by color. And so let's say this is sort of the lighter greens, darker greens, lighter blues, darker blues, and there are just hundreds of kinds of paper and all kinds of different textures. Some of them are almost not even like paper, they're almost like lace, but they're just fibers from plants, something like that. This is an example of some of my work. I'm actually gonna walk you around the studio to show you some in-progress pieces, pieces that are finished. These three are finished. This one is kind of a fall piece, and it has black trunks, gray trunks, light trunks. I was trying to show fog. This is more of a winter piece. There's a sunflowers piece. I don't know if you can see all the texture in it, but it kind of sticks out and has bumps in it. That's what texture means, having sort of a feeling to it. I'm gonna walk over here. This is a four series pieces of the four seasons. And you can see summer, fall, winter, spring. And I had to make the tree look the same in each one and the background the same. And then this is sort of like a barn door with the vines on it. So this piece I finished very recently. I'm happy with that one. This one is a flower, a daisies piece. It is not finished. I kind of have it up here, but I'm not done with it. This is a little cardinal, a winter piece, almost finished. This one is finished. This one is of kids playing in the snow when everything is just white and black with the trees, and then you have the bright colored scarves and hats, and they're building a little snowman back there, and I was trying to show kind of the fun of playing in the snow, which hopefully we'll have this winter, I hope. Now these are some that aren't quite as far as that. These are two I'm working on, just kind of, they're of different views of Jerusalem. I was trying to show that. I haven't done a lot of the details yet. And this one I just started. But you can kind of see two approaches to the same thing. This is one I'm working on that sort of has someone by the water. I haven't glued on the grasses yet, things like that. I work in layers, background to foreground. Here's another one that's almost done. It's sort of a village, and up there, I was not happy with the sky, so I actually was gonna rip it off. And then when I started ripping, I loved how that looked, so I did more ripping. So sometimes mistakes, often mistakes, end up being something that really helps your work. So never be afraid of mistakes. Mistakes are very good, and they're how you learn. This is a piece you can really, just gonna hold it so you can see it sticks out. This has a lot of texture in it. It's not quite done yet. I haven't quite gotten these all glued down and figured out, but this is a piece based on a little balcony I saw in Europe. And I often work from photographs. These are just some photographs of that kind of thing. And these are just different pieces in progress. Here's another tree piece showing kind of those white birch trees or aspen trees. And I took a little pencil and put the lines on or paint. Here's a beach scene. You can tell I do many different subjects. And I haven't quite glued the grasses on yet, but I worked for the sky, then the water, then the sand. Then I put on the chairs and the umbrella and the grasses. So that's kind of how I work, layer by layer. And here are just a few more that are kind of, they're finished. Here's a water scene, like a aquarium. I'm gonna finish up by talking about the paper. Sometimes the paper will give you ideas. And you might, you know, there are so many different things that the papers will make you think of depending on what you pick out and what you find. There's just like little treasures in that bag of papers. So here's my cat, by the way. This is one of our cats, Princess, who likes to come in the studio and work with me. And I think that's it. Thank you so much, and have fun.